Welcome to today's lecture. Today we will be studying about the dorsalis pedis artery. The dorsalis pedis artery is a chief palpable artery in the dorsum of the foot. It is the continuation of the anterior tibial artery. So if you see this picture, what you're seeing here, so this is the dorsalis pedis artery. So this is the lower end of tibia, this is the lower end of fibula. So this is the medial side. So this is the medial malleolus, this is the lateral malleolus. So coming to the course of this dorsalis pedis artery, it begins in front of the ankle in between the medial malleolus and the lateral malleolus. Then it passes forwards along the medial side of the dorsum of the foot to reach the proximal end of the first intermetatarsal space. So these are the metatarsals. So this space between the first metatarsal and second metatarsal, it is called the first intermetatarsal space. So it reaches up to the proximal end. So this is the proximal end, here this is the distal end. So it reaches up to the proximal end of the first intermetatarsal space. Here it dips downwards between the two heads of the first dorsal interosseous muscle to enter the sole of the foot. So in this picture, what you're seeing, so this is the dorsalis pedis artery which is coming. So here you can see it is entering the proximal end of the first intermetatarsal space. Then the muscle what you're seeing here, so these are the dorsal interosseous muscle. So it dips between the two heads of the first dorsal interosseous muscle to enter the sole of the foot. It ends by anastomosing with the lateral plantar artery to complete the plantar arterial arch. Now coming to the relations of the dorsalis pedis artery. So superficially, that is above, you're having the skin, then the superficial fascia, then the deep fascia, then what you are seeing here, so this is the inferior extensor retinaculum. Then you are having the extensor hallucis brevis muscle. So this muscle what you are having, this is the extensor digitorum brevis. So this muscle which is coming towards the great toe. So this muscle is the extensor hallucis brevis muscle. So this muscle is crossing the artery from lateral side to medial side. So this is the medial side, this is the lateral side. So the extensor hallucis brevis is crossing the dorsalis pedis artery from lateral side to medial side. So superficially, apart from skin, superficial fascia, then this is the inferior extensor retinaculum. Then you are having the extensor hallucis brevis muscle. Then in deep you are having the capsular ligament of the ankle joint, then the talus, navicular and intermediate cuneiform bones. Then coming to the medial relation, so this is the artery. So medially what you are seeing is, so this is the tendon of extensor hallucis longus muscle. So medially it is the tendon of extensor hallucis longus muscle. And laterally, you are having the first tendon of extensor digitorum longus. So this is the extensor digitorum longus muscle. So you are having the first tendon. This is the first tendon of extensor digitorum longus muscle. So this is the first tendon, second tendon, third tendon, this is the fourth tendon. So you are having the first tendon of extensor digitorum longus muscle. And also you are having the medial terminal branch of the deep peroneal nerve. So the deep peroneal nerve, this is the medial terminal branch of it.
Coming to the branches of the dorsalis pedis artery, so first you are having the lateral tarsal artery, second medial tarsal artery, third you are having arcuate artery, and fourth is the first dorsal metatarsal artery.
So in this slide you can see this is the dorsalis pedis artery. Then the branches you can see here. So this is the
medial tarsal artery, this is the lateral tarsal artery, then this is the arcuate artery, and you are having the first dorsal metatarsal artery. Now, if you see this slide, so this was the dorsalis pedis artery, then this was the medial tarsal branch, and this is the lateral tarsal branch. So, if you see this lateral tarsal branch, it arises from the dorsalis pedis artery opposite to the navicular bone. So, the bone what is present here, so this is the navicular bone. So, this lateral tarsal artery is larger than the medial tarsal artery. So, it passes beneath the extensor digitorum brevis and it supplies this muscle and the neighboring tarsal joints, and later it forms the lateral malleolar network. So the lateral malleolar network is formed by anastomosing with the branch from the arcuate artery, then the lateral malleolar branch from the anterior tibial artery, then the lateral plantar artery, then the perforating branch from the peroneal arteries. Now, coming to the medial tarsal artery. So, these are 2 to 3 in number and they form a medial malleolar network by anastomosing with the medial malleolar branch of anterior tibial, then the medial plantar. Then you are having the malleolar as well as the calcaneal branches of the posterior tibial arteries. So they form the medial malleolar network by forming these anastomoses. Now coming to the arcuate artery. This is the arcuate artery. So it is the large branch that arises opposite to the medial cuneiform bone. So, this is a medial cuneiform bone. So, opposite to it, it arises. So, it runs laterally over the bases of the metatarsal bones deep to the tendon of extensor digitorum longus and the extensor digitorum brevis muscle. And they end by anastomosing with the lateral tarsal and lateral plantar arteries. So, you can see these are the tendons of extensor digitorum longus and these are the tendons of extensor digitorum brevis. So, you can see the arcuate artery which is running deep to the tendon of extensor digitorum longus as well as the extensor digitorum brevis. So, in this slide you can see this is the arcuate artery. So, it is describing a curve with the convexity in front. So the convexity of the curve is in the front and it is giving off the second, third as well as the fourth dorsal metatarsal arteries. So these are the dorsal metatarsal arteries, that is second, third as well as fourth, which has been given from the arcuate artery. So if you see in this picture, so this was the arcuate artery with the convexity in the front. So, it is giving rise to the second, third and fourth dorsal metatarsal arteries. So, you can see that each dorsal metatarsal artery, they proceed distally on the corresponding dorsal interosseous muscle and in the cleft between the toes, it divides into dorsal digital arteries. So, you can see at the cleft between the toes, it has been dividing into dorsal digital arteries. The dorsal metatarsal arteries anastomose with the plantar arch by 3 proximal perforating arteries and 4 distal perforating arteries. Now, coming to the first dorsal metatarsal artery. So, it arises just before the dorsalis pedis artery enters the sole of the foot. So, you can see here, this is the dorsalis pedis artery which is entering the sole of the foot. So, just before that, the first dorsal metatarsal artery arises. So, you can see here, this is the first dorsal metatarsal artery. So it extends forwards into the cleft between the great toe and the second toe to divide into dorsal digital arteries. It also gives a branch to the medial side of the big toe. Coming to clinical importance, the pulsations of the dorsalis pedis artery are easily felt between the tendons of extensor hallucis longus as well as the tendon of extensor digitorum longus muscle. Secondly, a diminished or absent dorsalis pedis pulse indicates it is due to the block in any of the proximal arteries due to thrombosis, embolism or arteriosclerosis. Due to this, gangrene of the foot occurs. So you can see, because of no blood supply to the tissues, the cells die, and you can see the bluish discoloration of the skin, and it leads to gangrene. So the symptoms include severe pain, which is followed by numbness as well as foul smelling.
Thirdly, in 14% of the people, the dorsalis pedis artery is congenitally absent. In such case, the pulse can be checked by palpating the posterior tibial artery. Thank you for watching.